dApps in een Debian project. We need volunteers for the Debian system. So if you know a little bit about Perl or C or whatever, go to the Debian wiki and try to help out to make it possible to use Debian on embedded systems. Because there are a lot of work that needs to be done and the resources are getting sparse, so we can use all the help we get. And the same goes for the JIDA tools, but that's more if you like programming on C and C and GTK, go to the website of the JIDA tools and try to get some hacking there. Now that was it. Are there any questions? I have some examples about your project. I can show some chips and some PCBs or whatever. Can you repeat that?
What sort of tools are there for doing stuff like Aeronaut or VHDL?
Those tools are there. The question was if there are tools to create very high-speed decryption language tools and real hardware, like, let's say, I'm going to get there, like this. Yeah, it's still working. In hardware development, you can create the real chip itself with open source tools, or you can just buy the components from the shelf. And the question here was, what tools are there to actually create the hardware? And that's not really my department, but these are the tools you can use for real hardware development. And they are there, and kind of the same issues goes on there. It's possible to create hardware. I have seen real chips made with free software development tools. But it took a little bit of effort to get it right. And it's possible to use, I believe, the 45 nanometer process is possible to do that with open source tools. So you can create pretty advanced designs with them. Both of these tools do, this is a very high speed decryption language. And this tool is for hardware development. So it's all possible, it's really great, just try it out. Also contact the mailing list on the Fedora Electronics Labs, because they are the place that you can go to for real hardware development. Any questions? You want to see some examples or some other stuff on the end? The microphone is getting there.
Actually, not so much of a question as rather a complimentary notice about synthesis. To my knowledge, all your VHDL or your chip fabrication process will go all the way to a simulation, but the synthesis part, whether for proprietary FPGA manufacturers or for fabrication, will require a proprietary software for the last synthesis step. I'm not sure if you're... At some point, there was Alliance that was able to synthesize VHDL for low-end Xilinx FPGAs, but that's no longer feasible. And to my knowledge, you need some proprietary software for a final step.
If I understand the question correctly, the question was there are a lot of chips like the Xilinx FPGA chips, and when you create code for them, even with open source tools, you need them proprietary tools to put the code into the chip. Is that correct?
Not only to put it into, but for the last synthesis step, the generation of a binary file that you will put into Xilinx chip, as well as for fab silicon ASIC fabrication, will require something like Cadence or whatever synthesis software you're using. But to my knowledge, there is no open source tool, simply because the formats, not for lack of wanting, but because the formats are all proprietary and will not be divulged to open source software programmers.
Yeah, indeed, with the Xilinx chips, you need libraries of the vendor to create your code that you can put into your device. So you can use open source tools to put the code in, but to link it with the chip and to say where all the cells of the FPGA are and all the libraries, you have to use a proprietary software project of the vendor. And that is especially the case with Xilinx chips and with those advanced FPGAs. And that's really a vendor issue, because the vendor didn't open their tools. But I hope in the future they will see some light and they will create some kind of open SDK toolkit, kit or whatever. The solution we kind of use for it is we don't use FPGAs anymore, but we use advanced ARM processors. And the ARM is, it's kind of an open, all the tools are open, the chip itself is not open. But there are several vendors that are selling the ARM processors, so you can choose between several vendors. And this, you have also different tools that you can use for the ARM, but you are limited to the capabilities of ARM processors and all that kind of stuff. So that's kind of the workaround for the current ecosystem if you want your complete tool chain to be open. Some other questions? No, nothing. Should I demonstrate some pictures from the OpenARM project? Let's see. One of the cool things we did, when we created our system, we wanted to get information about the bill of materials and all that kind of stuff. And so, well, we are using open source tools, so why don't you hire somebody to just create a very cool script that just takes all the information out of the open file format of the schematic design and create a nice output generation of that. So we just hired some Perl programmer, and he went hacking, and a few months later we got a nice tool chain that created a nice text file with complete bill of materials. That was kind of cool. So that's possible with those open source tools. Let's see where I put them. All this information, it just generated automatically out of the open schematic files, and it just creates all the parts information and the bill of materials, and it also lists the prices. So that's one of the neat tools when you got a complete open toolchain. You can just link everything together with it and create the prices out of them. And also you can link it against Fresnel or whatever company you use for to get your prices. And then you get automatically updated price modules of your project you created. And that's just not possible with proprietary development tools unless you cooperate with those tools, with those vendors of those tools to create those things. So this is just an example of a bill of materials, but the same thing also can be done with the PCB tool and the JITA tool. If you want backwards or forward annotation, you can install a little program that somebody create. And when you create changes in your PCB tool, it also directly goes to your JITA tool. So there's a lot of effort going on to synthesize all those connections between all those little tools to create a really good, effective environment to create those PCB to create your hardware. Other nice things. And the same goes for, let's say, we got automatic generation systems to create PDF files and PNG files and a website out of all the schematics. So you don't really have to do any effort for that. It's a loading for my remote file system, so it's kind of slow. We also use an automatic system to create all the symbolic parts. So one of the cool things too.